Hello, good morning class, and welcome to today's session for English literature. And we are going to start with our course today. We are going to resume our course today after a long break. So pay attention and please stay with me throughout the video. So today we are going to start with The Merchant of Venice. That is the drama that is there in your course. Some portion you have already read in class 9th, and we have already revised class 9th portion. Now we are going to start from Act 3, Scene 1. As in this scene, we come across the fact that Shylock has come to know about the losses that Antonio's ship has suffered, and then Shylock has also come to know about his own loss, that is the elopement of his daughter. So he is very sad, and all this transpires in this scene. So now let us quickly come to the text and see what happens. Act 3, Scene 1. In the book, it is on page number 108. Act 3, Scene 1. Venice, a street, enters Salanio and Salarino. Salanio, now what news on the Rialto? That is, what is the news from the stock exchange market? What is the news from the market? Please tell me the news. Salarino, why yet lives there unchecked that Antonio hath a ship of rich lading wrecked on the narrow seas? The good winds, I think, they call the place a very dangerous flat and fatal, where the carcasses of many ship, a tall ship, lie buried, as they say, if my gossip report be an honest woman of her word. Now he's saying that we have already got the confirmation that Antonio's ship has wrecked, and it has wrecked at the same place where few other ships of very, very heavy material, the ships which were made up of very good quality, they had already suffered loss in that region of the sea itself, and that is the region where Antonio's ships have also wrecked. So, and I think this is a confirmed news, and if it is not the confirmed news, I wish that it might not be the confirmed news, and it might just be like a woman who gossips, lady who is a very good gossiper, who always spreads rumor. Salanio, I would she was as lying a gossip in that as ever Nab Ginger, or made her neighbors believe she wept for the death of her third husband. But it's true, without any slips of proximity or crossing the plain highway of talk, that good Antonio, the honest Antonio, oh, that I had title good enough to keep his name company. Now Salanio is saying that I know that, let me tell you that Madam Rumor, that is the person, that is the lady who used to tell lies, who used to spread all sorts of rumor in the town, that lady, she was a big gossiper, and she was a gossiper to such an extent that she would chew ginger, and she would then say that, while chewing ginger, just like ladies who sit on the streets and talk in a low class society, just like that lady, he's saying that it is just like that lady who keeps ginger in her mouth and then tells people that she cried even when her third husband died. But then after all, after I say all this, let me tell you that I think we should not beat around the bush. We should come to the main topic, that is, we should discuss about the loss of Antonio's ship. And I think that the loss that Antonio has suffered is actually a real loss, and there should be the loss that good Antonio has suffered has actually happened, and that is why I have attached the word good to it. Salarino, come, the full stop. Now Salarino is saying come, he is asking Salanio to come accompany him and put an end to the story that he is telling about Antonio's ship, about the loss of Antonio's ship. Salanio, ha, what sayest thou? Why the end is he hath lost a ship? Salanio says that what did you say? The sum and substance is that Antonio's ship are lost. Why are you asking me to pause and to move with you? The whole gist of the story is that Antonio's ships have already been lost. Salarino, I would. It might prove the end of his losses. Now Salarino says that I am very sorry, and I feel that it might be the heaviest loss that Antonio might have suffered. He says that I hope it might be the end of his losses. That is, he has got nothing to lose after this. Whatever he has lost is the end of all the losses, and I think that there is no loss after this. Salanio, let me say amen be times, lest the devil cross my prayer, for here he comes in the likeliness of a Jew. Now Salanio says that since you are saying that it is the last loss that Antonio has suffered, and he might not suffer any loss after this, let me tell you, let me say amen. Amen is a word which is said whenever we say something good about anything or about any person or about any place. Then that it is used in good reference, and whenever we want whatever we say to come true, then we say amen. So he says that let me say amen before some devil crosses my prayer. That is before the devil comes, and if I am not able to say amen, so let me say amen for Antonio's loss, that he might not suffer any loss after this. Because then he says that the devil is coming in the form of a Jew, that is Shylock. Enter Shylock. How now, Shylock? What news among the merchants? Now he is inquiring from Shylock. How are you, Shylock? And tell me, what is the new news among the merchants? Merchants are people who do commerce or business, who do trade. So what is the news from the merchants? Shylock, you knew none so well as you of my young daughter's flight. Flight means elopement. Elopement means to run away with someone. So Shylock says that you better than anyone else know well. Shylock is saying that you are inquiring from me about the merchants. Let me tell you that you know very well about the loss of my own daughter, who has already eloped, who has already run away. Now we'll come to know with whom Shylock's daughter has run away. Salarino, that's certain. I, for my part, knew the tailor that made the wings she flew with Hal. Now Salarino is saying that is quite true, that I was aware of the fact that she was about to run away, and the fact that I knew the tailor also who had stitched her garments wearing which she eloped, she ran away. Salanio and Shylock, for his own part, knew the bird was fledged, and then it is the complexion of them all to leave the dam. Now the meaning of the word fledged is ready to fly, and now Salanio is saying that Shylock was also aware of the fact that his daughter was ready to fly, ready to run away. And then he says, and then it is the complexion of them all to leave the dam. And it is the nature of, now he is saying that it is there in every girl's nature that after some time, when a girl grows up, then that girl is ready to leave their parents' home. Similarly, this girl was also ready, Shylock's daughter was also ready to leave his home, and that Shylock was also aware of the fact, according to Salanio. Shylock, she is damned for it. Now, she will be damned for it means I am cursing him for it. For what she has done, I am cursing her for it. So now we know that's certain, if the devil may be her judge. Now Salarino is saying that she will be damned only when a person who is very devilish in nature will judge her. She will be damned only when a person who is very devilish in nature will judge her, then only she will be damned. Shylock, my own flesh and blood to rebel. Now Shylock is saying that she was a part of my own blood and flesh, and she is the one who has rebelled. She is the one who has run away without informing me. Salarino, there is no difference between that flesh and hers than between jet and ivory. Jet and ivory means black and white. Now he is saying the difference between, Salarino is saying that the difference between your flesh and her flesh is just similar to the difference between jet and ivory. There is a huge difference between black and white. Similarly, there is a great difference between your flesh and her flesh. More between your bloods than there is between red wine and Rhenish. Rhenish is white, expensive. Rhenish. Rhenish is white, expensive. German wine. Now he's saying that the color of the blood also differs from yours to hers, just like there's a difference between red wine and white, costly and supreme quality German wine. Just like there's a difference between that wine and red wine, similarly there's a difference between the color of your blood and her blood. Then he says, but tell us, do you hear whether Antonio have had any loss at sea or no? Now Salarino is saying that keep this matter of your daughter's elopement aside and I am asking you and you tell me that have you come across the fact that Antonio has lost his ship or not? Shylock, there I have another bad match. That is, now he is saying there also when I had signed, now he is referring to the bond that has been signed between Shylock and Antonio, and he is saying there also it was a mismatch for me. It was a bad bargain for me. It was a mismatch for me. A bankrupt, a prodigal. Prodigal means a spendthrift, a person who spends money without even thinking. So he is saying that he is a bankrupt now because he was a prodigal. He was a person who used to spend money without even thinking. He had spent very lavishly and now he has become a bankrupt. Who dares scarce show his head on the Rialto? A beggar. What used to come so smug upon Mark? Let me look to his bond. He was wont to call me usurer. Usurer means a money lender. Let him look at his bond. He was wont to lend money for a Christian courtesy. Let me look at his bond. Now he is saying that I had another bad experience because I had signed a bond with such a person who has become a bankrupt and who used to once brag off about his money, his wealth, and he used to spend without even thinking. He spent very lavishly and he was a spendthrift. And he is saying. That who can hardly show his face on the exchange. Now, since he has no money, so he cannot go and show his face on the business front, on the exchange market. And he is saying he is a beggar now who used to come smiling, so self-satisfied to the market. Now he has turned himself into a beggar who once used to come to the market in a very happy mood, smiling. let me take care of this bond. Now he's saying, let me look at his bond. Now I am going to take care of whatever has been mentioned in the bond. Then he says, he used to call me a money lender. Let him take care of his bond. Now Antonio used to humiliate Shylock. So Shylock is saying that once he used to humiliate me and he used to call me a money lender. And now he's saying he used to lend money free of interest as an act of Christian charity. When he had money, he did not care about making more money out of that money, and he used to give that money to people without even charging any interest from them. Let him take care to redeem his bond in time. Now it is a time for him to repay for his bond, for whatever has been mentioned in his bond. Now we'll stop here, children. Thank you so much for watching my video, and please do follow me and do keep yourself updated till I upload my next video. Thank you so much and have a nice time, all of you.